PreviewsWorld.com.
I'm at the Avatar press booth interviewing Scott Murphy and Zach Penn from Hero Worship, and they're going to take a few minutes here to talk about the new series that's, I think it's out now. Did it just get the first issue? First issue just came out, and we're here to share some secret information with the fans here. At least that's what I'm trying to hope for, and basically get a feel for what's going on.
Yeah, no, the book is about, you know, Zach and I were talking about what if there really was a superhero in our world, and what would the impact of that be, and what sort of fans would crop up around that hero, what sort of fan culture. And so it kind of takes a look at like what comic book fans would be if there were really superheroes. And it deals in particular with one fan, a kid named Adam, and the superhero Zenith, and the interaction that those two have. It sort of unfolds over the course of our book.
And so you basically come behind and say, no, it's going to be this instead. And I got creative control, right? And then this fight starts.
Yeah, none of what Scott said is true.
That's what we want.
Yeah, it's, right. It's like a little indie book about, no. It is what Scott said, but it's also, I mean, part of it is, the idea is to take the kind of superhero universe you get in like a Marvel universe or the DC universe and try to bring it down to as real, you know, as gritty and real a background as you possibly can, and really examine the nature of the fan to the hero. Like, you know, the sense that this kid worships this guy, but he isn't necessarily any better than anyone else, and in fact might be worse. So, and it's always an assumption in superhero books that the person who's getting the abilities is the right person to have them. And that's something that we explore over the course of the first arc is that in fact the case. So it's pretty gritty, pretty violent, you know, more gritty and violent than the movies I work on in terms of that story about this superhero.
Right. So you're able to take certain liberties with this that you couldn't do in, say, like, you know, the Avengers or the X-Men movies or anything like that.
Yeah, and in the way that, like, you know, in the X-Men, when Wolverine sticks his claws into someone, no blood comes out,
right.
You know. That doesn't happen in this book. You know, when Zenith tries to save someone, he's saving some people from an industrial accident, and one of them falls, their body smashes against the ground, and it's disgusting. And
good job, man.
Yeah, thank you. No, but and you know, but it's important to us to kind of establish that that's the world it's in. And the kid, Adam, who's the main character, is from a real neighborhood in Los Angeles. He's kind of mixed race. He has a lot of problems at home and in school, and his interest in Zenith is kind of unhealthy, you know, borders on obsessive. So, you know, we're trying to kind of take all those conventions and put a real spin on them.
Now that sounds like a lot of imagery to try to conjure in terms of coming up with this type of original scenery. What do you use for inspiration when you have to sit down and try to make what's coming out of this guy's head on the page?
Well, you know, we have a great artist, Michael DePascal, who you know, has been doing great work for us, and we both send, you know, he takes the scripts, and, you know, he will send us pencils, and, you know, and Zach and I will both have input on that, but
we have a lot of notes,
but it's a great, you know, opportunity for us to sort of shape the visual side of the book that normally we don't get when we're writing movies or TV, because here we have a lot more input as far as like giving notes on the pencil stages and then at every stage of the artwork after that. And it's been really gratifying, and Michael's been doing great work for us.
Well, we've completed the first six scripts.
Okay.
And the first six issues are all in pretty much various states of production, but they'll be coming out soon. And there's a complete arc being told in these six issues, but we definitely have set this up as a world that should expand outwards as we, you know, as Scott said, I think before, there's a lot of setups in this first issue. I mean, a lot of things that are hinted at or kind of set up for the audience, and then as each issue unfolds, the universe is getting bigger and bigger and bigger. So even though the end of the sixth issue really does wrap up this kind of mini arc between Adam and Zenith, the world itself is a place we'd like to keep, you know, telling stories in, right?
Is that about right?
Yeah, that's exactly it. We wanted to make sure that we had the first volume, basically these first six issues, told a complete story and sort of set up the world and the relationship between the two main characters. But Zach and I also had a lot more ideas that we couldn't fit into the first six issues. And so there's definitely room to sort of build the world out and to start expanding on the ideas that we sort of set up in this first volume.
Well, it sounds like you got a lot going on. It sounds like this thing is just getting started and there's a lot to look forward to. So, gentlemen, I want to thank you both for taking time to talk to me. I know you're very busy, and I'm really, really, you know, loving this stuff. So, folks, here we are here at Avatar Press talking to Zach and Scott, and check out Hero Worship from Avatar Press. It's out at a store near you. Keep the faith. Keep reading comics.
Previewsworld.com.